Welcome. Let's begin with the 18th December paper, the second shift, the second set of questions. As we said, the questions this time were tricky. Now, the first question, let's begin with that. Which of the following have the same meaning, of the same meanings, is incongruous? So here we clearly see prosperous, flourish and thrive have the same meaning. The only different one is excite, and therefore excite would be the answer for this question. This question is very, very conceptual. Understand this very carefully. Now, first thing is, there are four people: Rajesh, sister, son and daughter. Now, we definitely know Rajesh is the father of son and daughter. So, Rajesh's age cannot be the same as son and daughter, but the sister of Rajesh could be of the same age as the son and daughter. Now, when you have two sentences that are given here, you have to understand that in this case, we are applying such a logic that both these statements have to be true. Now, the second statement says best player and the worst player are of the same age. So, let's say daughter is the best player. In that case, if I say son is the worst player, my first statement gets incorrect because the player's twin and the worst player are of opposite sex. But in this case, both of them become the son itself. So this is not possible. So what I can do is I can pair up the sister of Rajesh with the son of Rajesh. Now when you are doing so, let's say the sister is the worst player. So worst player and the best player twin, okay? So best player's twin is the son, are of opposite sex, that is clear. One is girl, one is boy. And the second statement, best player and worst player are of the same age. So sister can be of the same age as daughter, as we said. So here the right answer is, who is the best player would be the daughter of Mr. Rajesh. Very, very important, very, very logical, very, very conceptual question that was asked. And to solve these questions, you have to understand that both of the statements have to be considered together. The next question, paralanguage, a very direct question. So pitch of the voice, use of pause and rate and volume of speech, all of those are part of paralanguage. It has nothing to do with the noise element. So these three become your right answer. The next question is, smoking is injurious to health. A warning is printed on the cigarette packet. Now, what is the assumption behind this? We are not talking about argument. A lot of students got confused considering this to be an argument. But what is asked here is an assumption. So when I'm putting such a mark on the cigarette packets, what is the assumption? The assumption is the people will read what is written on the packet and they would take this as a careful note. And therefore, A and B are the correct assumptions. Make sure this question was regarding assumption, not argument. I repeat again. Next question. Which of the following influences effectiveness of communication in a classroom instruction in a critical way? Now, the question says effectiveness of communication. Now, when you have communication, style, intelligence or subject knowledge does not matter because it's talking about effectiveness of communication. So what would matter is the teaching aids here. Now here you have a very interesting question on data interpretation. Understand this question very, very carefully. First you have general information that's given. You have universities from A to G that are given. The number of foreign universities enrolled in university C are given. You have the number of total PhD students in university C, which are 855, and the total students, which are 570, who have completed their PhD programs. Based on this, you have two tables that are given. Now, the first table, in the first table, you have percentage who joined the PhD program and who successfully completed. You have the value as 5700 that was given in the previous slide. So 5700 students are there. So this is out of 5700. So 18% out of 5700 is something that is given. Now, when you have the percentage of the students who joined the PhD program, in this we know about university C, which is 855. So that's 10% is 855. So total I can calculate, and of that total I can find out. So total would be 8550, and then of that 22%, 15%, 10% that I'll have to calculate, that we have done in the next slide. But this is the information that's given in the question. So in the question you have two tables. The another table shows the number of foreign students in the university C only. So just for university C, I have the data of the number of foreign students in the PhD program. Now, remember, there are two tables for the same data interpretation question. Now, the first question says, what percentage of students in University C are foreign students? So that's very, very simple. I have the total number of students in the University City C, which are known, which is 855. And from the previous slide, I can add up all the values of the foreign students here. And I can say, okay, the foreign students comes to be the sum total, that is 171 divided by 855 into 100. And that's the percentage of the students that are enrolled in the student who are foreign students in the university who are foreign students. So that comes up to be nearly 20%. So 20% becomes my right answer for this question. The next question is a little tricky. Now, once you have created a table for this question, all the remaining questions would go with the same concept. So when I have percentage completed, that's given, that is the total is 5700. So I can calculate the total students who completed their PhD in each category. So 18% of 5700, 17% of 5700, and I have the respective values out here. Here, I have the percentage of students who joined the university. So, I have C as 855. So, out of the total 8550, I can calculate 22% of 8550. That would be this much. And I have the individual values for this. And then I have percentage of students who passed out. That is the total who completed that we calculated divided by total who joined into 100. And that would give me the percentage passed students. Now, once I have all these values with me, I can attempt the question very simply. Which university has the highest percentage of the student who completed their PhD program as compared to who joined? Now, from this, I can see highest percentage is for 86.66%, and that's for University C. So, University C becomes my right answer. Again, make sure answer is C, but it is in the choice D. So, while marking in the answer copy, you have to mark very, very carefully. You have to mark choice D, not C. That is a common silly mistake that most of the students do. Now here, the ratio of the students who completed to those who joined in University G. So University G is here. So that's 864 divided by 1368. That's in the ratio 1:2. So you have the answer as 1:2. Again, a very simple question that was there. Here, you have to find out the number of students who completed the PhD program from universities A and D. So, A is this value and D is this value. That's the values they completed. Then, number of students who joined in C and E. So, I have the values 855 and C and E 684. Now, I add up 1026 and 912, and from this I subtract 855 and 684, and the value, the difference would be my answer, so it would be 399 as the right answer. The last question says, in University E, how many students are there? I have University E, how many students are there? It is 512 students who completed their PhD, and I have to find out what is the percentage. If there are 21 African students who joined, what is their percentage in the university? So the total students who joined, 21 out of this total would give me the answer. So 21 divided by 684 into 100 would be my right answer. The next question, a very simple question, don't put a lot of concepts in this. Where you have no hydrogen sulfide that is produced, there would be clean water. And when you have the highest quantity that is produced, that would be the darkest color. And the middle ones would be the variation. As the pollution increases, the darkness of the water increases. So as simple as that, the darkness, the dark color increases. The next question, very, very interesting. You have CC, that is copy 2, and BCC, that's blind copy. So blind copy is not known by Sohan, not known by Rohan. Okay. So Sohan knows that Rohan received the email because Sohan is the one who is sending the email. Rohan knows that John receives the email that is incorrect because John is in the BCC. And therefore, Rohan cannot know that John is receiving the email. But John would surely know that both Rohan and Sohan have the email because he is in the BCC. The rest of those are not in the BCC. They are visible to those who are in the BCC. So this would be correct. And Sohan knows that the birthday party would be held because he is sending the message. So he obviously knows it. So these three statements would be the correct statement. This statement would be the incorrect statement. A simple, very simple question that you have commonly worked around if you are using Word document. So that's copy and paste. So if you have to take a same document section and put it onto the other section, what you do is copy paste. If you are not cutting it out, okay? So if you are cutting it out, you are removing it from the first section and putting it onto the next section. For promoting human value system. Now, this is a very important question that was part of the MHRD document and very, very important related to NGOs. So you have Association of NGOs basically helps in promotion of human value system for university programs in India. So that's the correct answer. Now, here you have to match the correct choices. So you have the correct choices where we say ROM is a permanent memory, RAM is a temporary memory, LCD is the screen monitor, and the rest one is the definition for CPU, that's controlling all the functions. So a very simple question where you know the basics, you can match it out. Blue Revolution is related to fishery. So full potential of the fishery, fish farmers and development of integrated fishery are the correct options. It has nothing to do with new areas of research where we call about marine finfish. So that's not correct. It's not related to forestry, not related to botanical gardens. The next question is the function of the institute which looks for teachers' education. So National Council for Teacher Education, from the name itself, you can derive the right answer even if you are not aware of the concept. But this is a very common list of organizations that you need to know, the institutions you need to know. Digital divide is a gap between the digitally literate and the digitally illiterate people. So those who know the use of resources vis-a-vis those who do not is what is digital divide. So a very direct question based on the definition. Now here, a very important question on NEPA. NEPA has been a very, very important section every time you have a question from NEPA. NEPA is considered as a deemed to be university. And when it's considered as a deemed to be university, you have capacity building, research and planning along with fully maintained by Government of India like any other central universities. So this A and C would be your right choices for this question. The next question, you have to match the kind of pollution. Point and non-point source of pollution is related to water. You have chemical fertilizers related to land pollution, sonar related to noise pollution, and then you have thermal power emissions related to air pollution. So that's a kind of very simple question again from the environment section. Very important question, which of the following program in university aims at value education and holistic frame? So the correct answer is NCC, the National Cadet Corps, that helps in a value education in a holistic framework. So second question based on value education, very, very important. We'll be covering a detailed lecture on these topics that have proved to be very important in these examination. The next is, which of the following unit of university is considered as a statutory unit or has a statutory function to perform? So the correct answer is finance committee and board of governors. Since board of governors is not the choice, here you would have finance committee as the right answer. The next question is, under the Environmental Protection Act 1986, we are talking about improving the quality of environment, preventing, controlling and abating the environmental pollution. So those that's the correct answer, or basically the definition of the EPA Act 1986. The next question is, in the context of university or schools, which of the following aspect of environment determine the academic ethos? So when we are talking about the character of academic institution, we are talking about the pattern of human relationship as it is evident in the workplace, and that's the correct answer for this question. The last question talks about device driver. So device driver is basically a software which allows an interaction between the peripheral components and the operating systems. So that's the correct match for this question. So with this, we covered the last set of 25 questions for 18 December second shift paper. Before your NET examination, we'll be having numerous series of live lectures and another important topics that have proved very, very important in these papers. So we'll be covering all those topics. And yes, in the description below, you will have the links to access all the explanations and detailed information on all the resources from us. Have a wonderful day ahead.